Okay. Yeah. So we've got. Let's see what's coming up. We've got Mickey Mac Mac's going to be down at the Hawk Trees again.
Oh, God, Mickey, why are we sending him back down there again?
He literally just got out of the hospital.
Did he ask for it?
I don't think. I think Boss Ron was just like, get Mickey back out there.
Not gonna lie, between you and me, I'm starting to question some of Boss Ron's decisions lately. But that's above my pay grade.
That is above. I mean, you don't really have a pay grade right now.
I know. I keep using that as a figure of speech, but
it's something that's just a normal thing. Just slips off your tongue.
You know, my accountant keeps sending me a bill, and I keep explaining I don't have any money to pay the bill. It's like
he would know.
Catch 22 there.
Yeah, he would know. He's got access to your accounts.
Killed me.
So we've got that coming up. Shetland Creameries, I don't know if you've heard in the news, they're still missing their cattle.
Oh.
So we'll probably talk a little bit about... Oh, shit. Hold on.
Yep.
Oh, Jesus. Hey, man, I got a split. It looks like my water heater just exploded. You know what? Hold on. I'm going to see if there's someone in the hall or something that can take over. Give me one second.
Okay. Just going to chill here. Little bits. Oh, Mickey. Yeah, would you mind? It's okay. You know, I told him not to go that close to the trees, but man doesn't listen.
Okay. Mic check 1-2-1. Mic check 1-2-1.
Hey.
Okay, let's go ahead and do this.
This is Alec Baldwin.
Hello, kiddies. This is Alice Cooper.
Hey, everybody. My name's Joel.
And I'm Benji.
We are from a band called Good Charlotte.
Hey, yo, Hulk Hogan here.
Whisp Turlington.
Hello, this is Angus Young and...
Brian Johnson of AC/DC.
Hi, this is Tom Johnston.
And Pat Simmons
of the Doobie Brothers.
Hi, this is John Mellencamp.
Hey, what's up? This is Ryan from Drowning Pool.
Hi, this is Steven Tyler from Aerosmith.
Hey, baby, we're hopping and bopping and popping with the best bet for the boss beat at the top of the pop smash. Go with the timely tunes for those with a textured taste. Shut up, Dave. No time to waste. This is Diamond David Lee Roth.
Hey, this is Don Barnes.
And this is Danny Chauncey.
And this is Donnie Van Zandt.
And we're 38 Special, and you're listening to
The Whisp Turlington Show. Well, it's quite a shock to be doing the Turlington Show here on 108.9 The Hawk, but Jason Gore does have a family emergency, some kind of home emergency. So we are here, and Whisp Turlington Show is on the air. It's a wonderful thing to be back on the air. You may know we did this show from 1974 until 2014 right here on 108.9 The Hawk, syndicated across the nation for RockNights. We did that at night. But it's very good to be here in the studio, finally doing some radio. Looks like I do have someone in the studio with me. Didn't expect that. But Geoff the Angry Man Garlock, hello, how are you?
Whisp, wow. First, a big fan. Did not expect this.
Did not expect this on my end either.
Okay. Impressive intro cart, have to say.
You know, well, a lot of people have been on the Whisp Turlington Show. As I said, we did do it from 1974 to 2014. So it's had a lot of opportunities to meet people, to make friends, and long lasting connections.
So you're friends with these people?
Everyone you heard in that card, best friends.
Really? I mean, holiday cards come around, you're sending one out to every single
cards.
One
cards.
Holiday cards. Wait cards. A second. How are much money are you making, Whisp Turlington?
Well, I'm getting at least six figures just to do this show.
Wait, excuse me?
So what I like to do is, instead of holiday cards, I get a big old box of fresh pasta and fresh sauces from the Sauce King, 828 Hog Street in Valverde.
That's the best sauce in town.
Sauce King sends it out. Alec Baldwin gets it. He immediately calls me, says, thanks for the sauce, King. What I get from him, cars. Drugs.
Interesting.
It's a friendship that has lasted for years. I met him on the set of Working Girl. I was there to interview Melanie Griffith about this fantastic film. Ended up having quite a wonderful time with Sigourney Weaver on set. And, you know, Alec and I became fast friends on the set of Working Girl.
When you say you were... Well, two questions I've already got here, Whisp. So
yeah,
you were... like, how close with Sigourney?
How close? Married for 16 years.
Excuse me. I did not know this. I have checked her Wikipedia before. I do not remember seeing anything about...
Yeah, well, I asked for it to be removed.
I suppose that is a lot of power there. Wow.
We got married on the set of Ghostbusters 2.
Interesting.
Yep, right in front of the Vigo the Carpathian painting.
Of course, you don't need to explain to me. Love that actor from Die Hard as well. Happy holidays to everyone.
We had our reception in the sewer that was filled with all of the slime.
You had the reception still with the slime, with the ooze?
I said, hey, this ooze looks groovy. Why don't we keep it? Wow. And Ivan Reitman looked at me and he said, you got it, Whisp. Ivan Reitman, another man on the Sauce King list for the holidays.
Really? Man, the Sauce King list keeps growing. Is it always like a marinara-based gravy?
You know, it's a little marinara. It's vodka sauce. There's some fettuccine Alfredo sauces in there. Wow. What also really makes it is all of Sauce King's fresh pastas.
I mean, the best...
828 Hog Street.
Best in town. I mean, I could only dream to get on this list, it sounds like.
Yeah, well, you would be a lucky man if you could. You would be.
Okay, well, maybe speaking after of, this... Yes.
Is he going to keep interrupting?
I'm not trying to interrupt. I'm supposed to be a co-host here with you, Whisp.
No. That's great. It's good to have you here, Geoff.
Okay.
You know what? Maybe I'll put you on the list.
I could only hope. I'd even take just a marinara.
No.
Oh, okay. Well, you make the decision.
Do you know what you will take?
What will I take?
A big old box of sticks. It's Renegade on 108.9, The Hawk.
Hello, Farmer Dan down at Shetland Creameries. Normally at this time of year, we would say it's creamin' time down at Shetland Creameries. But unfortunately, we cannot, as our cattle is still missing. I had literally searched everywhere in Valverde, and I just cannot find them. If you see them, they do have names like Juniper and Horse. But if they do not respond to those names, those probably are not my cattle. If you do happen to see them, please comment on the post that I just put up on Instagram. And also, please, please, please stop coming to Shetland Creameries. All I want to do right now is fulfill your dairy needs. But I can't, because the cattle, they're just not here at Shetland Creameries, where the cream is still missing.
Here's what people are saying about 108.9 The Hawk.
Oh, yeah, they fucking rule.
Eh, they're okay.
They're my favorite radio station. Ka-kaw! That's a hawk sound, right?
108.9 The Hawk. The Beatles, Revolution on the Whisp Turlington Show, 108.9 The Hawk. Of course, everybody's talking about that new Peter Jackson documentary on Disney Plus, The Beatles Get Back. I watched it over the weekend. I enjoyed every second. You know, I've been close with Sir Paul McCartney for about 23 years now. We met on the set of, actually, a little longer than we met on the set of Spies Like Us. You know, I was there and I was like, why don't we do part of this movie in the snow? And that made McCartney laugh. And ever since then, you know, he's been on the sauce list.
Oh.
Of course it is, so you know.
We have you to thank.
Excuse me.
Show. Oh, sorry. Sorry. Go on.
Greg.
Geoff. The angry man.
Garlock. Oh, well, it's wonderful you're here. Didn't know you would be, but it's really great that you're hanging out. Let me just finish my McCartney story.
All right, sorry. Go on.
So he's on the sauce list. He gets a box of sauce. I get a call. And he's like, well, this is the best sauce I've ever had. And I'm... Greg.
Geoff.
And I'm like, yeah, man. That's what I do for my friends. I send them the sauce. Well, it is the Whisp Turlington show here on 108.9 The Hawk. Big news in the news. Of course, the cattle at Shetland Creamery is still missing.
Hoping to find those cows soon.
Yeah, what's the latest you've heard about that, Greg?
Geoff, the angry man. Garlock, news reports that we did see them down by O'Shantahan's. Of course, the only kosher Irish bar in all of Valverde. They were in the back milling around by the garbage, and I think the owner shooed them away. So we had them, then we lost them.
Nobody likes a garbage cow.
No, that is true. So hide your garbage, but keep your eyes peeled for the cows, because I need that creamery to be bringing me these holiday treats, please.
You know what, reminds me of a story.
Okay.
Yeah, I was rooting around in some trash with Peter Cetera. He was still in Chicago at the time. And we're rooting for trash because someone had thrown away some gold. We were, of course, at the... hold on one second.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
We were, of course, at Teddy Pendergrass's party, and he was like, I've got all this gold here, and I'm going to throw it away. And Peter said, you better not. And I said, do it, Teddy, because we're still going to find it. Yep. Those were the days back when... Radio was radio, and gold was found in the trash.
Is that a back in the day? I know you've maybe been at this longer, but that...
What a story. What a story.
It feels like a confusing story. I'm not even going to lie. The amount of... The elements don't exactly add up there.
I'm surprised that a Circus magazine never asked me for that one.
It does sound like it could be a Circus headline. You really do have a long list here, but also I'm starting to notice that you've got a couple of sketchy people on this list.
Okay, here. Who?
I mean, you depending on
who,
how
Greg?
Much you've been... Geoff, the angry man, Garlock, no matter who you've been reading in the news there, you seem to be good friends with Alec Baldwin, who's just had some troubles throughout the years.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if he's ever talked to you about them. I don't know if you've been keeping up.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you're even listening to me anymore, Geoff, the angry man, Garlock. Yes?
We've all had problems.
In fact,
I remember.
That was your summary? We all have problems. Okay. No, go on. You have another story here. Yep. Tell
me. No, I mean, we all, don't you have problems, Greg?
I've got plenty of problems. I got, I'm not getting paid.
Why don't you tell me one of your problems, and I'll see if old Whisp Turlington can help you out. I need bed music, though. Greg, go ahead. Lay it on me. What's your problem?
Geoff, the angry man, Garlock. Well, I mean, my biggest problem right now, I suppose, is just money. I haven't been paid by 108.9 The Hawk in quite a while. I'm sitting still on all of these children's books I wrote that explains how the Beatles actually stink. I've lost...
Well, that's not true.
Read the book. Maybe that's why they're not selling so well, but I could have an argument that I could make with you. I know you're probably good friends with Ringo.
I would say best friends with Ringo.
Okay. Well, and
like
I...
Very good best friends. VGBFs.
Very good best friends. Yes, I get that. That still doesn't change the fact that I have no money coming in. My Chevy Malibu was stolen.
You know, there was one time.
Okay.
Ringo phoned me up, and he said, I'm having some money issues, Whisp. You got to help me. And I said, well, you know, have you guys thought about doing, I don't know, maybe pull out one of John's old songs? And I don't know. Hold on.
Oh, yes.
Our family show here.
Maybe you call Geoff Lynn from the Electric Light Orchestra or the Traveling Wilburys, and you get him in, and you guys, you get George, you get Paul, and you finish that fucking song. And you know what he said to me?
What, Whisp?
That's real love. That was also one of the songs that Lennon had left them to play.
Yeah, I started.
Real Love and Freeze a Bird. Freeze a Bird was on Beatles Anthology 1, and Real Love was on Beatles Anthology 2. Now, they were going to do a third song called Ricky Dicky Doo, but apparently it wasn't good enough.
Did you suggest that they should do that one, though?
I actually called, and I called Geoff Lynn, and I said, Geoff, if you put that fucking Ricky Dicky Doo on the record, I will fucking end you.
You said those exact words to Geoff Lynn.
And then Geoff said to me, as long as I'm still on the source list, I'll do it. Wow. And you know what? He did it. But then the next year, off the sauce list.
Oh my gosh. You know, I...
You don't fuck with Whisp Turlington.
You know, Whisp, pretty quickly I'm starting to realize I thought you were just a big old name dropper, but I'm...
Fat Bottom Girls, Queen on 108.9. The Hawk. There are 20 radio stations in Valverde, and we're at the very bottom of that list. 108.9, The Hawk.
Are you craving a hot dog? Of course you are. Then come on down to Fletchy's, Valverde's only New England-style hot dog stand. They're not boiled, and they're not on a barbecue, but they're split down the middle the way a hot dog should be. And if you ask for anything different, I'm gonna split your skull. That's right. I'm not joking. I'm sick of it. This is how a hot dog should be. So come on down to Fletchy's, where we've got our recession special. Two split-top hot dogs and a large Pepsi with ice for only $2.99. That's right, with ice. Stop asking without ice. This is the way it should be. And if you ask again, then I'll give you a choice. You either get defenestrated off of the roof of this building or a blood eagle, which is an ancient Viking torture technique where I split the skin off of your back and put it into eagle wings. So come on down to Fletchy's. The way we serve hot dogs is the only way you should be eating them. Deal with it.
Hey, y'all, it's Big Truck from 108.9 The Hawk inviting you down for the truck race. Yeah, we're going to be racing trucks all day long this Sunday from 4 a.m. until 4 p.m. Now, that is a non-stop truck race. These trucks, these big rigs are going to be going around in circle, in circle, in circle, in circle, in circle, and the last truck that doesn't puke, they win the prize. Another truck, but one that has not been thrown up in. So come on down to the annual truck race down at the Valverde Valley Truck Speedway and give your donation to help some kids for the Hawk Trees, where we're actually not getting much action on the Hawk Trees because of so many hawk attacks. So we got to help these kids this holiday season, and we're doing it with the annual truck race. I'm Big Truck, and I'll see you down there at the Valverde Valley Truck Speedway this Sunday for the annual truck race on 108.9 The Hawk. Toot toot!
This is Alec Baldwin.
Hello, kiddies. This is Alice Cooper.
Hey, everybody. My name's Joel.
And I'm Benji.
We are from a band called Good Charlotte.
Hey, yo, Hulk Hogan here.
Whisp Turlington.
Hello, this is Angus Young and...
Brian Johnson of AC/DC.
Hi, this is Tom Johnston.
And Pat Simmons
of the Doobie Brothers.
Hi, this is John Mellencamp.
Hey, what's up? This is Ryan from Drowning Pool.
Hi, this is Steven Tyler from Aerosmith.
Hey, baby, we're hopping and bopping and popping with the best bet for the boss beat at the top of the pop smash. Go with the timely tunes for those with a textured taste. Shut up, Dave. No time to waste. This is Diamond David Lee Roth.
Hey, this is Don Barnes.
And this is Danny Chauncey.
And this is Donnie Van Zandt.
And we're 38 Special, and you're listening to
The Whisp Turlington Show. Whisp Turlington on 108.9 The Hawk, filling in for the one and only Jason Gore. Here with my buddy Greg Daniels.
Geoff, the Anger Man, Garlock.
We got a great show for you today. We've been talking Beatles. We've been talking sauce. We've been talking Teddy Pendergrass. We've been talking Peter Cetera. You remember all those great people that used to come on the Whisp Turlington show? Well, they're still in my heart.
I can't lie to you. The intro, that cart was really impressive at first, and now it mm-hmm. it's starting to feel like a documentation of people that you manipulated and controlled over the years.
What, like I'm a collector? Like I collect human beings, Greg?
I mean, I did not jump there, and yet you did. So I feel like that your answer is in your answer right there. Well, Geoff, by the way, Geoff, the Anger Man, Garlock, not Greg.
Why don't you answer me this, Greg?
Geoff.
What would you do to get on the list?
Oh, I mean, that's the thing. I'm in fear here of the list, because it seems like the power that you have been wielding over classic rock is formidable, and yet I envy it. I love classic rock so much, and I also could use a little help at this point. And now I mean, I hesitate to say I would do whatever I could to get on that list. I would do whatever I could to get marinara and Alfredo.
Oh, you wouldn't get the Alfredo.
Could I get a cacio e pepe?
No.
I'd still do whatever I could to get the marinara.
Well, see, and that's how I easily collect you. We'll see by the end of the show if you're going to make it on the list. Let's check in with traffic. Of course, traffic brought to you by the Sauce King, 828 Hog Street, Valverde. Looks like we got an 80 tractor trailer collision. That's 80 trucks have collided. Fire can be seen from any building in Valverde. Why did they collide? Nobody knows. Did anyone survive? Hell no. So just make sure you're not driving out on 180 right now. We've got a bomb scare on 525. Is it a real bomb? Yes. Did I put it there? Yes. Will you find it? No. So don't drive on 525. And that's traffic on 108.9 The Hawk.
I do have to just jump in. I just have to do some clarification. I'm not a detective. I'm just kind of piecing together some knowledge there. Definitely watch out for that 80 car pileup. Sounds like it's going to make traffic a doozy for your nighttime commute. Two, did you orchestrate all of this, Whisp? Are you pulling the strings once again?
With what?
Sauce. It seems like it's all coming together. It seems like that the traffic report was sponsored by the Sauce King, and you seem to allude that you might be like a diabolical supervillain for Valverde.
What?
I'm just telling.
What?
I mean, honestly, I'm not even really just piecing it together. I feel like you told us at the end the 80 car pileup, maybe that's it, but the bomb. Like you admitted to it. I don't want to look. I don't want this to affect my my possibility of getting on that sauce list.
Oh,
I
got the list right here, buddy.
Oh no!
Hear it.
I hear it.
You hear the list.
I take it all back. I don't think I think you were just giving us a normal traffic report for every day in Valverde. You don't
feel like that was a normal traffic report?
No, it was.
Okay.
It was. Okay, it was fine. Totally normal. And there was no manipulation No, fair. No fear created by a mastermind.
Fair. Let me, Greg,
Geoff,
just to appease you.
Okay.
Allow me to do what I think you would consider to be a regular traffic report right here on the Whisp Turlington Show.
All right, give it a roll.
Traffic is at a standstill. Hearts are being questioned. Who will save us? Who will find the bomb on 525? Are there other bombs? Say, in other DJs' homes? Near their hot water heaters? All that and more coming up on the Whisp Turlington Show.
You didn't hear that. You didn't
hear... I don't know what you're talking about at all.
I mean, did Christopher Nolan write this? I mean, that was like a straight up... the Hans Zimmer bed music.
Oh, my friend Chris. Oh. What a great, great man. Reminds me of the time that he was done with all that Batman stuff, all that goofy, goofy Batman stuff. Nobody likes that. And so he says to me, got an idea. It's going to be a movie. And I said, oh, stop right there, Chris. Better be a movie. You don't make TV shows. And he laughed at that. We both just sat back and pondered that for a second. We laughed for a good time. And then I said, hold on.
That was a long
rail. I said, what I want from you, Chris, is a movie with buildings that fucking fold in on each other. And he said to me, I don't have any fucking ideas like that. I thought I was going to do Green Lantern. And I said, you do not do another goofy fucking superhero movie. You want buildings that fucking fold in on each other. And he said, I'll do it. And then we went to Hawksmoor in London and had a great meal.
Starting to realize what happens here. The problem is what I should have glommed onto in your example of a normal traffic report is I believe you are threatening that you might be murdering Jason Gore, but
no way.
The problem I'm realizing is your storytelling is so goddamn good. Your anecdotes are so intriguing. Every single time you bring up a new celebrity, I'm like, how does he know him? How will he get to the list? And more importantly, what piece of important pop culture will he help have a finger on? A finger on the pulse. A finger on the neck. A finger.
Speaking of fingers.
Oh, boy. Here we go.
Tony Iommi comes after me. Oh,
don't do this
and
to
he
Tony.
Says, hey, I'm going to work at a factory before I get my little band called Earth off the ground. And I says to him, go work at that factory.
You son of a bitch.
Go do that, because your band Earth is never going to get off the ground unless you've got that it factor. And he said, what? What do you mean by that? And I said, just go press some metal. So he went in there, he pressed the metal. And while he's pressing it, I'm at the machine behind him.
No.
And I trip him.
No.
He falls in, he cuts off his fucking finger.
Oh my God.
And he's like, what am I going to do? Earth's never going to get off the ground now. And I said, shut it, Iommi. Here's a fake rubber finger. You're going to go play guitar for Jethro Tull for a few days.
Oh my God.
Then you're going to get your ass back in Earth. You guys are going to change your fucking name to Black Sabbath. And my friend, Greg.
Geoff, thank you.
At that point in time, heavy metal was born.
You bastard. I don't know whether to call the police or give you a kiss on the cheek, because you seem to have manipulated the birth of one of the greatest offshoots of classic rock and proto metal into heavy metal, the birth of the greatest riffs that have ever existed, the birth of using drop D tuning, and you almost killed that man.
Here's a clip of me on RockNights with Tony Iommi.
You're a monster.
And you're going to hear how we talk a little bit about that situation. It's RockNights on all of your local radio stations. We are worldwide here. One of the greatest rock and roll guitarists, heavy metal guitarists around. The one and only my good friend Tony Iommi. How you doing, Tony?
Right then, doing great there. It was great to see you, Whisp.
It's always good to see you, Tony. Hey, Tony, you remember that time I cut off your fucking finger?
I thought we weren't going to bring that up by
now. No, why would I have you on Rock Nights if we weren't going to talk about the time when I cut off your fucking finger?
I thought you were trying to murder me. I don't
Well, I wasn't. I was trying to murder the normal norms of rock and roll and create something a little new. But I knew that in order for that to happen, something had to be done. It had to come from pain, Tony.
You know, I look into your eyes and I see that there's some people who just want to watch the world burn. And I feel like that might be you, Whisp.
Well, you're damn right, Tony Iommi. Tony, tell me, what do you see in my hand here?
I see the list, so please
don't... I got a piece of paper. Is this the sauce list? Are you still on it? Let's see.
Don't cross it off.
Oh, let's see. Here we go. Ronny James Dio on it. Vivian Campbell on it.
Is Richie Blackmore still on there?
Richie Blackmore still on the list. Getting all of the sauce. Tony, I don't see you on the list anymore.
Oh, no.
Tough break.
No, don't do this to me.
That's been Tony Iommi on Rock Nights. We're coming up with the rest of Death Leopard on Rock Nights.
I need the sauce!
And there you go, a clip from Rock Nights with me, Whisp Turlington.
I feel like you played that as a threat to us. As a threat to me.
In case you don't remember which show you're listening to, here you go.
This is Alec Baldwin.
Hello, kiddies. This is Alice Cooper.
Hey, everybody. My name's Joel.
And I'm Benji.
We are from a band called Good Charlotte.
Hey, yo, Hulk Hogan here.
Whisp Turlington.
Hello, this is Angus Young and...
Brian Johnson of SADC.
Hi, this is Tom Johnston.
And Pat Simmons
of the Doobie Brothers.
Hi, this is John Mellencamp.
Hey, what's up? This is Ryan from Drowning Pool.
Hi, this is Steven Tyler from Aerosmith.
Hey, baby, we're hopping and bopping and popping with the best bet for the boss beat at the top of the pop smash. Go! With the timely tunes for those with a textured taste. Shut up, Dave. No time to waste. This is Diamond David Lee Roth.
Hey, this is Don Barnes.
And this is Danny Chauncey.
And this is Donnie Van Zandt.
And we're 38 Special, and you're listening to
The Whisp Turlington Show. Get on your knees, Val Verde, because the rock and roll is back.
I can't.
Whisp Turlington Show, filling in for Jason Gore on 108.9 The Hawk with my good buddy Greg the Talons Margolis.
Geoff, the Anger Man Garlock. I can hear the fear in all of their voices now. I thought at first it was just a fun list of all of the great experiences you've had, but I can hear in Good Charlotte's voice that you were the puppet master behind their rise and inevitable fall, because there's no other way that band could have been popular. You are a monster.
So here's what happened with Good Charlotte.
Oh, boy.
You know, they sent me their demo tape. Hold on a second. Go drink some coffee. You know, for the finest beans in the land, you want to go down to Coffee King. 828 Hog Street. Val Verde.
Do you have a coffee list? Don't do this to me. I can't not be on two lists. God damn it.
What do you think I give out every Halloween?
I can't believe
Sacks
you're giving
the Coffee
that?
King.
Oh, God.
Every kitty comes up to my door, and I'm like, you're not getting candy, kid. You're getting a sack of Colombian beans. And they look at me, and they're like, I can't fuck with this dude. It's Whisp Turlington. My dad's afraid of him. My mom's had relations with him.
Wait a second.
I'm going to have to take these beans. And I'm like, you're damn right. You're going to have to take these beans.
It was bad enough when it was adults, but now you have kids involved in this? This is like some diabolical plot out of Halloween 3, Season of the Witch. Are you threatening to kill the children with this coffee beans? Is that what is going on? Am I just piecing together craziness here?
I never kill. I only control. So speaking of control, Good
That's
Charlotte.
That's supposed to be better. All right.
Joel from Good Charlotte sends me his tape, and I'm like, this is garbage. I want to hear something a little more hip. I want to hear something that really talks to the kids. He sends me another tape. Still garbage. But they're attractive young men. So I call my buddy Clive Davis. Oh, and I say, Clive, remember that time I saved your life? And Clive was like, yeah, I do. I was riding in a car with Vince Neil. And the car began to skid.
Oh, my God.
And this was after Vince's other car issue.
Oh.
And anybody would be like, why would you get in a car with Vince Neil at that point in time?
Okay.
Phew. But Clive did.
Thought you were admitting to Razzle's death.
There. No, no, that was clearly Vince Neil.
That was just pure cocaine and alcohol.
Pure cocaine.
Okay, good to know. Good to know pure that was cocaine. Just life.
But little did old little Vince Neil know that Whisp was riding on top of that Mazda Miata.
Oh, God.
I pull my knife.
What?
I cut right into the rooftop.
Oh, my God.
They're going 123 miles right down Santa Monica. Clive looks up at me. Fear like I've never seen before. And trust me when I say this, Greg.
Geoff, the angry man, Garlock.
There are many moments when I've seen nothing but pure, 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 unadulterated fear.
I can only imagine at this point.
And I see it in Clive's eyes and I say, Clive, it's time to go. I take one toot.
Oh boy.
I reach up. There's my helicopter's rope ladder. And in my other hand, little bitty Clive Davis. And we're rising through the air. And I set him on top of Capitol Records. And he's like, I don't live here. And I said, you do now.
My God.
And ever since then, Clive Davis has lived on top of Capitol Records.
He lives
and,
up
of
there.
Course, Vince crashed that car.
Oh, of course. I mean, that just goes without saying. That's just Vince Neil for you.
And that's how Good Charlotte got their record deal.
I feel like there's so many scarier elements involved in that story that I almost forgot we were talking about Good Charlotte and their record deal. But, I mean, I guess it does explain that terrible band being semi-popular for a brief period for terrible people. I guess the main thing I'm learning here truly is never meet your heroes. All right. You were a hero of mine, Whisp, but
I'm not a hero anymore.
Oh, well.
Greg Danielson doesn't feel like being a Whisp Turlington fan anymore.
Oh, Geoff Garlock, the angry man. I'm still a fan as long as it gets the sauce. I'm just pointing out it's just a different experience than I imagined. Lot more horrific. Did not realize that you were the puppet master behind everything. Was Metallica's Master of Puppets written about you, is what I'm starting to wonder.
Yes.
Oh. Ask a stupid question, get a simple answer.
Get a simple answer.
Yeah. Okay. Well, should have just...
Kind of reminds me of another time when I was selling arms to the German government. And they said, what do you want for these arms? They were guns, Greg, not real arms. I want to make that clear.
Yeah, Geoff, weapons. Geoff knew that. I was guessing.
And so I said, I'm going to need you to put together a rock band with Paul Rogers from Bad Company and Jimmy Page from Led Zeppelin. I'm going to need it to be called The Firm. And the German government said to me, done. And the rest was history. The greatest rock band in the world was formed.
That's a bold statement.
And here's their number one song for 44 years. Top of the charts, can never come down. It's Radioactive on 108.9, The Hawk.
Are you ready to hear the evilest music in all of Valverde? Well then check out
The Hellhole,
hosted by me, Robbie Agatocles Dalton, every other Wednesday at 2 to 3 in the morning. Yeah, that's right. We're going to be bringing you the evilest underground metal on 108.9 The Hawk. All of your favorites, from ceremonial disembowelment to necroptic ingurgitated putrefaction. And if that ain't heavy enough for you, check out the last 5 minutes of the show for our truest, most cult music with
Dark Side of the Swamp.
Yes, it's all the best in black metal, one-man depressive black metal, on black metal, funeral doom, porno grind, porno power metal, porno doom, NWOBHM, NWOSDM, NWOSSDM, NWOXTBE $4, doom, and one Skinnerd song that my dad's making me play. So remember, keep it true, keep it cult, keep it death with
The Hell!
Only on 108.9 The Hawk, Valverde's only classic rock.
You're listening to 108.9 The Hawk, Valverde's number 3 classic rock station.
Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young from Deja Vu almost cut my hair. You know, David Crosby once told me the real story behind that song.
You know, I have to interrupt here.
Greg!
No, you listen to me. I've realized that you've been manipulating all of us for all of these years, and then you started that last anecdote before we went into that Firm song, and I had a lot of fears. I was worried you were going to somehow implicate yourself in the death of Cliff Burton. Somehow admit that you were behind the Scorpions' Winds of Change song and helping that to be pushed forward by the CIA to bring Perestroika.
Me.
And that would have all been scary as a world manipulator and a true monster, but
right.
You kind of lost some power when you created the Firm. I mean, it's a fairly forgettable record. It's not the highest peak of any of those. Remember, I mean, that song Radioactive is fine enough, but it's kind of a secondary thought. I gotta say, I feel like I was learning to live in fear of you, but now I'm starting to think that maybe you don't have as much power as you think you do. Maybe you're just a junkie.
Listen here, you talentless, showless, payless motherfucker. Paul Rogers came from both free and bad company. Jimmy Page came from the motherfucking Yardbirds and Led Zeppelin. Chris Slade came from Man for Man's Earth Band, Uriah Heep, later played for AC/DC, and Tony Franklin on bass. He didn't fucking come from anyone. What have you done?
I mean, that kind of breaks
up. Why don't
up
you write a children's book about the Firm?
I could
that
easily.
That nobody fucking buys.
Well, I'll tell you one thing, man. I think they'd buy just about as many copies of that as they did The Firm. I mean, again, I think it's more of just a great example of put a lot of great pieces together. Doesn't mean you got a good end result. I mean, The Firm is essentially a dollar bin record, always has been, always will be. And you know what I'm realizing here? Yeah, what have I ever done? Maybe I've done nothing. But you know what that means? You can't take anything away from me. Sure, maybe you can dangle your little sauce list over my head, but try blowing up my home. I don't even have a home. Try blowing up my car. I don't even have a car. Try taking my money. I don't have money. When you've hit rock bottom, that's the only place you go. You can't go any further down. So you try your best. You think you're a master manipulator? Well, I see through you. I think you're just a cocaine-ed up junkie.
You got me, Greg.
Oh.
Tell me, Greg.
Okay.
I apologize.
Seems like
for
I might have might have won that round.
I think you cut to the heart of Whisp, and I do apologize for it all.
Wow.
I apologize for everything.
Really? Well, I mean, it's, you know, when the devil apologizes for all of its sins, it still has those sins, but I guess that's a first step. Yeah.
Done a lot of bad things in my life, Greg.
Geoff.
I'm sorry. Geoff.
Oh.
And I'd like to atone for them. Tell me, Geoff, what's the one thing you love more in your life than anything?
I mean, classic rock. I mean,
outside of classic rock, is there a place in Valverde that really tickles you pink?
Oh, well, yeah, Flapper's Chicken Wings.
Flapper's.
It's a great establishment.
Mm. Yeah.
They've got over 25 sauces, and that's just on Mondays alone.
Yeah, it is.
So, yeah, I mean,
How much do you love this place, Geoff?
I mean, could eat there every day, five times a day if I needed to. Yeah. I love it more than life itself, I suppose.
Flapper's chicken wings.
Yeah. What is... I don't like the sound of that Hans Zimmer arpeggio.
Breaking news.
Oh, boy.
Flapper's chicken wings has just been raised to the ground.
No! You bastard!
Was it a drone strike? Was it a leaky gas pipe? No one knows. Actually, I do. It was a drone strike.
You son of a bitch. How could you do this? How could you do this to me? I'll never taste those honey sriracha barbecue ranch wings ever again. You're a monster.
You fuck with Whisp. There's no end to that. It's just you fuck with Whisp.
It's just a statement. I'm sorry. I'm sorry I said anything bad about the firm. It's not a bad record. It's totally
Road to Nowhere on 108.9 The Hawk. That's where you're going, Greg.
Oh, Geoff! Geoff!
Are you looking for the tastiest chicken wing in all of Valverde? Well, then look no further than Flappers. I'm Hunk Dankelman, the proprietor and owner of Flappers and the creator of the 20,000 flavor pyramid. That's right, we have over 20,000 flavors that alternate every single day. We just don't have the storage to keep them all. So go check out our Flappers GoDaddy website to see our schedule of flavors that alternates based off of the moon cycle. And for a limited time, we've got a new flavor for our number one customer, Geoff the Angry Man Garlock at 108.9 The Hawk. We don't know what the flavor is, but you know it'll be angry. So make sure you come on down to 64327 Steely Way next to the Flappers Memorial Overpass down here in Valverde. To Flappers, we ain't going nowhere.
Hair House with Mickey Mac-Mac.
I'm here with the guys from Slaughter. Hey, Slaughter, it's me, Mickey Mac-Mac.
Hair House every Saturday night from 9 until midnight on 108.9 The Hawk.
Lawyers, guns, money on 108.9 The Hawk. Three things that I have quite a bit of. Lawyers, guns, and money. Whisp Turlington on the Whisp Turlington Show, filling in for the truly magnificent Jason Gore. And we're about to wrap up the show. And before we do, I'd like to give you some of Whisp's thoughts. Whisp's thought number one. You don't need no vaccine.
No.
All you need is a copy of The Firm, the great album released in 1984.
It's okay.
That will defeat any virus out there whatsoever.
This isn't good.
Number two, if I'm in line behind you, let me go in front of you. Whisp Turlington does not wait. Whisp Turlington does not do any lines.
Just listen to what he says.
Just let me in front of you. Thought number three. Vaccines were made by robots.
Oh my God, we're back in the vaccines.
Robots from the movie Tron. I've seen it. I was on set while they made them. Geoff Daniels looked over me and he said, Whisp, is that what I think it is? And I said, you know it. Robot-made vaccines. Don't do it, Geoff. Well, he did it. And where has his career gone from there?
Was Geoff Daniels in Tron? I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt.
You tell me, Greg.
Geoff, no, was he wasn't. No, he wasn't.
Was he in it?
No. Yes. No. I don't know what you want from me anymore. You already took everything from me.
We've had a great show here on the Whisp Turlington Show. We've had laughs. We've had a lot of laughs. It's been good to be back on the air. This has been my first. Of course, I do Vinyl Winery every Saturday and Sunday in two slots that used to belong to Greg Daniels here.
Geoff, the Anchorman Garlock, he took my slots.
I took your slots. I took your chicken place.
Flappers.
And, yeah, seems like I'm taking your money as well, because Boss Ron told me that a lot of what he was paying you has been diverted to me. Kind of a tough time there, Greg.
Geoff.
But hey, Greg.
Yeah, Geoff.
I'm gonna do you a solid. Mm? Here's two gift cards to Flappers Chicken Wings. Use them whenever you want.
They don't exist anymore, but okay.
That's a gift from me to you, Greg. Hey, Greg, before we get out of here, I just want to ask you, what were your favorite moments of today's show?
Talking about the firm? Didn't expect to talk about that band on a classic rock station. I thought we had all agreed that they were just a adequate album. But
that's funny, Greg.
I guess I'm glad to have met you, and now I can understand how the world works just a little bit more and the machinations, you know, Greg, of Valverde.
A lot of people said it was Illuminati, but when in reality, it was just me.
My God. I've seen The Matrix.
Yeah, ponder that one. Oh, ponder that one for a little bit. Yeah, if I were The Matrix, there would be four pills. Be a blue one. There'd be a red one. There would be a Flintstones vitamin. No. And then there would be the pill. It's bigger than a horse pill.
Oof.
But it simply says classic rock.
Can I take that one?
Rectally only.
Oh boy. Okay.
Well, we've had a great time on the Whisp Turlington show. I'm going to leave you with one of the greatest bands to come out of rockdom. Reminds me of the time when I was in Detroit. I was in this shitty dive bar called Pickens. And up on stage is this weird bearded man wearing a fucking sports jersey. And I'm like, what the fuck is this guy? What team does he play for? The Detroit Beards?
Not a team.
I said that out loud and nobody laughed. Except for the man on stage. He was going by Bobby Seger at the time.
Oh, boy.
And he said, yeah, I do play for the Beards. You a fan? And I said, fuck no, I'm not a fan. Also, your town kind of stinks. Oof. And he said, yeah, I know.
What?
He said, I know, I've been trying to get out of this town for a while.
Wow.
And I said, if you could go anywhere, Bobby, where'd you go? He looked at me. He tugged on his beard. He wiped some of the spaghetti stains off of his sports jersey. And he said to me, Kathmandu.
Oh.
I think I'm going to Kathmandu.
We'll see you next time on 108.9 The Honk. Kathmandu. Geoff, have you ever been to Kathmandu?
Oh, I wish I'd been to Kathmandu. I got no kick against the West Coast.